Welcome to today's White House History Weekly. Today, November 3rd, 2020, is a very important day. It was 59 years ago today that First Lady Jacqueline Kennedy inspired the founding, the creation of the White House Historical Association. Since that time, we've had the honor to work with 11 presidents and first ladies. Our mission has remained the same through every presidency. We are a nonpartisan, nonprofit organization. Our non-taxpayer funding goes to maintain the beautiful museum standard of the White House interiors that Mrs. Kennedy envisioned. She also inspired in us an education mission to teach and to tell the stories of White House history, going back to 1792 when George Washington selected the site of land upon which the White House sits today. Sharing his perspective with us on the importance of our mission and our role with the White House is former White House Chief Usher Gary Walters, who served four presidencies spanning over 20 years.
Well, back when Mrs. Kennedy worked with the original founders of the White House Historical Association, it was a small enterprise trying to publish a book about the history of the White House and the people who lived there. It has grown today to be just a magnificent repository of information and the ability to pass out more information than was ever available. The electronic media that's available to people to get information from the White House, the school programs, education programs across the country. I don't think anybody ever envisioned the initial books. I think there was 150,000 of the original books that were published and were sold out very quickly would go to where it is today. As far as the direct impact on the executive residence, the President's House, the White House, the Historical Association has been magnificent in providing funds for the upkeep of some of the public rooms at the White House. And it has been instrumental in allowing First Ladies to pretty much renew the White House on a regular basis, which ends up being about every 10 years. The various rooms need to be redone about every 10 years. After all, there's usually over a million people that come through, and that has its wear and tear on everything from the floors to the furnishings, as well as the sun beating in on the drapes from the south side of the house. So the Historical Association has been marvelous in providing funding for those principal public rooms. Also started, as you well know, the preservation fund for a donation of various items that have been purchased for the White House. So I don't think that Mrs. Kennedy ever envisioned it to that extent, nor did the founders. But certainly what has evolved today is something that makes the White House a much more rich environment for people that come through, and the history has become the repository of is just as helpful to education as anything it could be.